Hi everyone, hope you are doing well from wherever you're watching this channel, depending on your time zone. Now, there is emerging news that President Uhuru Kenyatta, together with Raila Odinga, Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka, and Gideon Moi, had a meeting in the morning. And after that, Raila Odinga embarked to KICC to oversee the function of endorsing his running mate. Kalonzo Musyoka proceeded to Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka Command Center. But Gideon Moi decided to go at KICC. Then some few minutes later, he changed his mind. He left KICC to go and join Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka at Kalonzo Musyoka's Command Center. And so people are asking questions. Kalonzo Musyoka has decided that he's going to be on ballot because Raila Odinga has not named him as his running mate. Then another thing that is coming out clear is that Gideon Moi decided to go with Kalonzo Musyoka when he was unveiling his running mate and declaring his interest to run for the presidency. But again, the KANU party leadership was with Raila Odinga at KICC. Nick Salat was there to represent Gideon Moi. Where you see Nick Salat, just know Gideon Moi is here. So the questions Kenyans are asking themselves, what was Gideon Moi doing at Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka Center? He did not speak, but he was there. So I want you to watch this short video when Gideon Moi was arriving at KICC. Then after that, we are going to continue with this conversation to understand the real situation within Azimio la Umoja. Now we want to try and give our views on the possible reasons why Gideon Moi avoided attending the KICC event and decided to go and attend Kalonzo Musyoka's function. But before we go deep into that, just a quick request. You might be watching this channel but you have not yet subscribed. So my humble request, please consider subscribing so that any other time, once we release a video like this one, you will always get notified. Again, to all our channel subscribers and anyone who dropped a comment, I must say thank you so much for your unconditional support. Again, I'm requesting you to give this video a thumbs up so that YouTube can recommend our videos to more viewers. Back to our discussion. Now, this is what Kalonzo Musyoka said in his speech. I quote him, "I have ended my relationship with Azimio la Umoja, One Kenya Coalition, because Raila Amolo Odinga has decided to endorse Martha Karua as his running mate." So Kalonzo Musyoka has declared his interest that he's going to vie for the presidency on Wiper Party ticket and in Azimio, in a One Kenya Alliance. I don't know, the lawyers in the room, they can tell us how possible is that for Kalonzo to run for the presidency on Wiper ticket when he is in another coalition. He has signed another coalition agreement with Azimio. You can tell us in the comment section, kama anatucheza tu, ama is going on independent. So the question we are asking ourselves today, Gideon Moi, Kalonzo Musyoka came together with the other Musalia Mudavadi and Wetangula wenye walitoka, to form OKA, One Kenya Alliance. And so, Kalonzo Musyoka, when he was launching his bid, the truth is that Gideon Moi is not a running mate to Kalonzo Musyoka, but he is one of the founding members of OKA. Kalonzo Musyoka is a running mate by the name Andrew Sunkuli. So, what was Gideon Moi's business at Kalonzo Musyoka's center? He's not his running mate. And even when he was asked to speak, he did not speak. He simply decided to keep silent. So all this is telling, because at the same time, we have Nick Salat attending Azimio la Umoja launch of the deputy president. And he gave the speech. So what I can conclude in my view, Gideon Moi is not with Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka. Gideon Moi appeared in Kalonzo Musyoka Center just to spy. Gideon Moi has been sent by Raila and President Uhuru Kenyatta just to watch Kalonzo Musyoka and understand exactly what he's doing and how he's going about this issue. Because now Kalonzo is cutting his tie with Raila Odinga. He's an angry man. They don't choose him to be a running mate. Because if Gideon Moi is with Kalonzo Musyoka, the first thing he could have done is to come out and endorse Kalonzo Musyoka. Secondly, he could have been the running mate to Kalonzo Musyoka because, after all, they remain to be part of the founding members of OKA. Why bring in another new person? So it tells you that Gideon is simply watching Kalonzo Musyoka and reporting everything to President Uhuru Kenyatta and Raila Odinga, because Gideon Moi loyalty is with Raila Odinga and Uhuru Kenyatta. So there's nothing of friendship or brotherhood between Kalonzo and Gideon Moi. Because Gideon Moi, in the near future, he wants to run for the presidency. Kalonzo cannot help him to win election. He don't have numbers. He need the goodwill of the deep state and numbers. Numbers is with Raila Odinga, Uhuru Kenyatta, and William Ruto. So you need one or two of these people, or all of them, not Kalonzo. Secondly, Gideon Moi might just be still pursuing Kalonzo Musyoka to accept the position of Azimio, accept the chief cabinet secretary Raila Odinga is offering to him, and not run as an independent candidate or on Wiper Party ticket. That is another possibility. That's why he decided, rather than betraying Kalonzo and just staying here, let me show him friendship. Let me persuade him so that he can have a second thought. Sababu wanajua Kalonzo Musyoka, he can say this, tomorrow he will say something different. He said he will not appear for interview. But in the following day, he was appearing for the interview. He endorsed Raila Odinga. But now the following day, he was pushing for a running mate or nothing like endorsement. So today he can declare his presidential bid, and tomorrow he will be endorsing Raila Odinga. So we don't know. That's why Raila is keeping quiet about this position of the chief cabinet secretary. Because I thought, in my view, because Kalonzo is betraying Azimio, then the best thing for Raila Odinga to do is to hand over that position to Wycliffe Oparanya Ombeta. Yes, the finance slot is good, but this is not new to the Luyas. They have had it. Musalia Mudavadi alikuwa huko pia. They have had a vice president position. They have had a deputy prime minister position. The only thing they have not had is the presidency, kuwa president, na prime minister. So Kalonzo has refused this. Gideon Moi is just here maybe to persuade him. Because again, look at this. Kalonzo appear before Gideon Moi appear before Kalonzo event. Then when he asked to speak, he keep quiet. And then next alert attend ODM. Not ODM, but actually Azimio event. Then he's given a chance and he goes ahead to endorse Martha Karua, a person Kalonzo Musyoka is not happy with concerning the position he has been given. So already KANU is endorsing Martha Karua, but Gideon Moi is attending Kalonzo Musyoka event silently without endorsing Kalonzo Musyoka publicly. So it tells you that Moi is not here because of friendship with Kalonzo. He is only here because of the interest of Raila Odinga and Uhuru Kenyatta. as far as Kalonzo Musyoka's political position is concerned. So from tomorrow, we want to see if IBC is going to clear Kalonzo Musyoka to run for presidency, or again, if he will change his mind. The only good thing for Azimio side is that Kalonzo has not joined William Ruto. He might be on ballot. And therefore, there is some level of controlling the numbers that could have gone to William Ruto. I think we'll do a separate video on what next for Kalonzo Musyoka and Raila Odinga. So thank you so much for listening to me up to this far. May good God bless you and see you in our next video. But please remember to drop your comment. Let us understand your views about the current position in Azimio and the Kalonzo Musyoka's decision to pattern.